Even a granny can be your weapon.
Check, check, check. Should be hot on the mic, hot on the mic. All right, sorry about that, guys. We just did a reset of all of the... Whoop, let's delete that. Of all of our audio equipment. So we've been having some audio issues. Basically, we would have cutouts. So I reconfigured a ton of stuff. In hopes that it would clean it up, and apparently I missed some settings. So we're going to do a quick test here. This is the pain and suffering of taking everything apart and putting everything back together. All I did is put shit back the way that I thought I put it together to begin with. All right, stream mix is working. That is good. Stand by. Let's check our... All right, we've got our soundboard working, and let's double check our song requests again. GMC, I'm doing really well. It was a really fun weekend, really exhausting. I've been hard at work of trying to get my stream set up all the way back to the stable, set up the fire up the PC and just go stream setup that I previously had before I took it all apart to put it all on my massive desk. It's been a slow go of it, but we're almost there. Like I said, I had to do a little uninstall, reinstall. Well, I guess you didn't hear me because I was speaking into a mic that wasn't broadcasting. I've had to do a lot of uninstall, reinstall, reconfigure of items. So that part's been tedious, but it just goes with it. And I'm happy to hear that your finals are finally over. Just my college entrance exam remaining. How much longer until you take it? Hopefully it's not going to be waiting in the wind for forever. You're stuck studying all summer. Hopefully it's earlier than later. Let's do a couple quick checks here. Make sure I've got all my outputs for NDI. I'm going to do a quick YouTube check. 17 days? Oh, that's no time at all. Spinning TV. All right, we're getting our NDI source in there. Okay, guys, I think there was just a couple audio settings that I missed at the start of the stream. I even did a test, like, of all the items. I guess that was the final change that I made, ended up being the one that broke it all. But, shit happens. So, GMC, are you stuck studying every single day for your college entrance exam until that comes up 17 days from now? Or will you get a tiny bit of reprieve now that finals are over and you've got, well, almost 3 weeks, 2.5 weeks to get ready for that exam? Ooh, shit. Trying to drink my beer upside down. When that's over, I'm going to be streaming and going on trips left and right and center. Hell yeah, man. Well, I'm happy for you. Like I said, feels like you've been on the education grind here pretty hardcore all year, or all of 2019 thus far. So where are your trips planned then, GMC? What, you got some sweet destinations already on the books? Actually, no, I'm resting a bit. Then it's the start of the studies. Okay, good. You got to keep the mind and body fresh. You know, I like that. I like that. That's a good solid plan. Let's go ahead and pull up our preview screen here. We're lazy tonight, so instead of standing, we're going to be sitting all day. Or all evening, I should say. A lot of destinations in Iran, maybe one in Turkey. Okay. Good deal, man. Good deal. Hopefully a little bit of leisure trips mixed in with some fun enrichment trips, you know? A good mix of all of them would probably good for the mind and body. Get you primed and ready for some college entrance exams. We had, I'll say, moderate success on, like, 3 of our random squads PUBG matches last week. Let's see if we can get, like, a good, 4-for-4 run here tonight. Nothing but a sweet squad run here. It's going to be a gang of us going on trips and having fun, but that's after your exam. Okay. I'd rather go Jorg, personally. Ugh. I totally forgot about this damn having to alt-tab out of the screen for PUBG. I forget every time. And I'm all alone. Oh. What's the worst that could happen? I get blown up. Alright. Before we do anything, let's get synergy turned off. Stop. Okay. Now we can PUBG in peace. I've been having a blast on Apex, though. I think it's the best BR. So, we talked about it a little bit at length. A little bit at length, last Thursday night. The, my general understanding is that Apex Legends was going to get, it was going to continue to get better and better, right? From a stability standpoint. Stockholm was, thank you, by the way, there, GMC. Stockholm was saying that it's actually been considerably less stable, than previous, than launch, even. I guess with the number of updates that they've been pushing, it's just been a really bad, run of updates or whatever from a stability standpoint, which is really disheartening. You know, I mean, the game, I feel like, was doing so well at the start. I mean, there's no reason to think that it won't continue to or be able to pick back up the pieces where it left off. But yeah, it really was kind of sad to hear that from a stability standpoint is kind of taken away from the joy of the play. Disconnections are really annoying, but the gameplay is super satisfying, especially because I'm a Titanfall geek. Okay. That makes sense. I like I said, it seems like it all seemed to be things that they could fix. So hopefully from a stability standpoint, they're dedicated to making their product run really, really smooth. It seems silly that it wouldn't be, a kind of like priority one for them. I really enjoyed my time playing Apex. It was one of the games that I really sort of kind of fell in love with really, really quickly. It just happened by chance that on Black Ops 4, DLC was launching. Let's see, where'd my teammate? They're all in military. I'm going to go ahead and make my way over to towards Mansion. It was really... Well, let's go ahead and get this ammo first. It was really kind of, I would play this game more, but I'm sort of been sucked into Black Ops 4 DLC, so I was playing a ton of zombies. So, I wouldn't be, I'm not saying I wouldn't eventually maybe one day get back into Apex. It would be purely just as like a, hey, let's just go screw around and play some Apex. I don't think I'll be grinding it anytime soon. Oh, Jesus Christ. What a fucking mess. I can't believe I just wrecked a motorcycle and died. All fixable, respawn knows their shit. I'm surprised that it's been, laboring this much, that they haven't fixed it already, GMC. It seems wild to me. And you prefer it over PUBG and Blackout and Fortnite? Duh. I definitely would say I prefer Apex over Fortnite and Blackout. PUBG is, the BR that my heart longs for. It's the one that I long to play when it comes to BRs. Rarely do I have a craving to play BRs, but when I do, it's almost always PUBG. I think part of it's that PUBG was the one that I started with, right? I started playing PUBG two years ago? I think 2 years ago. So it's like, I played it a shit ton when it first was coming out, or when it was still in early access. And I was playing it a bunch. And I kind of long for some of the days that, when we were grinding PUBG, I think that's part of the reason that I have an appetite or desire to play it. Whereas Apex, it's kind of like it was in a mesh of BRs when I started to play it. Plus, at the end of the day, Call of Duty Zombies is what I typically like to play the most, or at least the most often. So, it's kind of like it had to compete with that as well. Since, we got a Treyarch title this year. The only problem with Apex is that it doesn't have solo. the solo and the fact that it's always three, right? So like if you've got a 4-man crew, it kind of blows. Unless they've since added squads. It's been so long since I've played it that they could have added squads, and I just don't even know. But it's okay. Like, I don't mind playing 3-man squads in PUBG. I kind of hated playing, I hate the idea of playing having 4 and only being able to play 3 in Apex. Oh, shit. Let's hit the corner house, maybe? Is this person, 321, gonna get there before me? Oh, shit, we got another squad. Alright, let's get some guns and let's wreck some people up. Fucking helmet. Broke dick. Not even a good one. I don't ever use this gun, but let's see what it can do. Shit! Whoa! Where was that from? Oh shit! Fuck, dude. I'm like trapped up in here. I need like my teammates to like go fuck that guy up some. Oh shit. Can I, like, go prone and get out of here? Prone blocked. Let's see if I can get my teammate up here without getting shot. Damn. Executed? We just got wiped hard. Who the fuck is he shooting at? Whole lot of fucking nobody? Oh, I was gonna say, I'm one hit away. That sucked. But hey, I got a revive, right? That counts for something there. You've been playing IW Zombies again, so my plan is to go back to IW Zombies after I've beaten all of the Black Ops 4's DLC, yeah, I guess. The lack of zombies in Call of Duty this year is kind of a nice breath of fresh air, because, like, I can go catch up on the IW zombies that I failed to complete previously. So I'll be on the IW grind with you not too terribly long from now, GMC. God, it's good. Josh gotta go. See ya. I don't know when. Bye. Alrighty, GMC. We'll catch you later, buddy. We'll catch you later. Creatious, welcome, dude. I'm gonna be there for the IW, boy. Yeah, yeah. So we'll get caught up, or we'll finish out the Black Ops 4 DLC cycle, and then we'll go back to IW, and then beat all those Easter eggs again, and start grinding on it a little bit. Just to, you know, like I said, go back and complete some of the maps that, you know, we left behind. We made it. What, we never completed Attack of the Radioactive Thing, and we never completed Beast from Beyond. Trying to think, yeah. We missed DLC 3 and DLC 4. Are the final two Aether storyline? They are. The last two DLC in Black Ops 4 are supposed to conclude, like, our prime Aether story. So it should be pretty good. That's why I said, like, I wanna stay focused from a Call of Duty zombie standpoint. I want to stay focused on Black Ops 4. We'll do a good bit of work there, and then we'll move on into IW to catch up where we left off. Yeah. It shouldn't take too terribly long once we get back into it, kind of picking up the mechanics of where we left off. But yeah, no, it'll be a good time. It'll be a good time. I'm looking forward to it. So that the lasers and the bomb, like, those were brutal. The lasers one night, it was embarrassingly bad. We finally got through the lasers after, like, 30 minutes of trying. And then, like, you know, everybody has to get through. And then we got to the bomb and just totally, totally fumbled, like, three times in a row. It was awful. Absolutely awful. But I expect that Easter egg to be a real pain in the ass to go back and actually beat. Bagels 10, Josh wet himself on the code step. Oh, get off of it, Kyle. It wasn't even my fault. I'm pretty sure it was all your fault. You probably just gave me the wrong code. I'm pretty sure that's the way it went down, Kyle. Seems like I'm here for a bit longer. All right, GMC, all right. I once aced the boss fight in the boss fight minigame. Oh, the, once they had the, post-DLC 4 boss fight battles. Where in the hell does my team want to go? Nobody wants to pick it? Fucking apartments? Fuck it. Let's go apartments. I mean, if everybody else is going there, we may as well. See how this drop goes. But I screw up so much in the laser cannon steps. Yeah, slide, the idea of having to slide under the lasers and then jump over them all in nice sequence, and the fact that four people had to do it successfully made for some shit times. Broke dick helmet. Awesome. There's a better helmet. Fuck backpack. A pistol. Alright, we're gonna do some work here. Well, no. Teammates. Gone. Dead. God rest his soul. Bagels, when are you gonna get online, buddy? We've got some work to do still in Black Ops 4 for you. I'll be playing this Tuesday, Thursday again, Kyle. Probably later than you care to start, though. I'm just, like, a skosh worried about only still having a pistol here. I mean, the one that you have to shoot it in the chest with the okay. The fact that there aren't any bad guns in Apex is awesome. I think that Apex, from a specialist standpoint and general game mechanics, is a real thing of beauty as well. But to me, the most impressive part was how smooth it was on launch. Like, the game was so well put together for an initial, like, a first release of a game. It wasn't like, oh, hey, it's really good, but stability's, like, an issue. It was like, no, they really just freaking went all out from a quality standpoint to start. That's why I said it was really disheartening when Stockholm was talking about how it's less stable now than it was at launch. One teammate over there. Got two teammates dead. Oh shit. That motherfucker. Gotta be fucking kidding me! How did he not die? Bullshit. Bullshit. And that you can ping everything. The ping system in Apex was fantastic. Except for when you get that tool of a partner who keeps pinging the Mozambique. Like, come on, man. Let it go. Let it go. They took their time on development. So I think they did a bang up job from a QA standpoint. Stability wise, it was excellent at launch. I think all the mechanics that they had in there felt fresh, new. It was a great spin on a BR with the way that they have all the specialists and just the overall mechanics. Like, hands down, like from a launch standpoint, they really, really hit their mark. I really thought that it was going to be the BR to end all BRs, yet it's funny, it's like a new BR comes out, everybody loves it, and then like the C settles and everybody goes back and plays the BR that they really, really love the most. And the pool of players just gets a little bit thinner. One thing I hate about my exams is that I started smoking because of the stress, gotta quit it. Oh man, yeah, you gotta quit that shit quick. I think I've smoked like 5 cigarettes in my entire life. I used to smoke cigars on occasion. I smoked hookah for like 2 weeks. And then I've, generally stayed away from smoking, which was, like I said, not a habit that I was really looking to pick up seriously. Where are we going, team? Oh shit, it's me by myself? That kind of blows. Yeah, we're gonna go out in Mansion. Hookah's a really popular thing here. Yeah. That's what I was gonna say. Like, I've smoked hookah. It was really awesome, but it wasn't something that I was gonna do regularly. I hate myself about it. So after the college entrance exam, I'm gonna yeet that shit. Yeah. I don't do it frequently, but I do it 2-3 times a month. I mean, the worry I always would have with doing it even just like infrequently, but doing it infrequently but still like on a regular basis is that like you could sort of sneak your way into having like more using it more often than you care to. Like, eventually. Son of a bitch. Still don't have anything. There we go. Fuck that guy. Why isn't he dead? Fucking douche. Should have lit his ass up. Oh shit, dude! That motherfucker was on point! Oh, damn. VSS. The thing about hookah is that it's super boring without friends. Well, yeah, no, for sure. We would always actually make a trip to our restaurant that was a hookah bar and smoke there just like as a big group. Always, it was a good time. I only smoke hookah when there is at least 4 of us. What the fuck? You can lean in PUBG? What the fuck is this shit? Yeah, the lean in PUBG it took me a really long time to unlearn the lean in other games. Even in Blackout, I'll still every now and then find myself pressing the Q and E trying to lean when unfortunately that's their whatever strafe. Like I can't remember if it's even got a key binding in Blackout, but the lean in PUBG is tough to let go after you play it long enough. Is it Q&E? I never knew. Yep. Q&E. Like I said, I can't remember what Q&E are in Blackout. Maybe equipment is E? I can't recall. But yeah, it's Q&E in PUBG by default, the default key bindings. It's like Siege then. So I've only played Siege 7-8 times, but I do recall there being lean in Siege. Q is alt and E is heals. Yeah, okay, yeah, that's right. That's yeah, duh. Yeah. It's definitely the alt, because it's Q is replaced in zombies with the specialist. Oh boy, I jumped late. Jesus, where's the fucking... I'm gonna drop short here. Oh, fuck. Let's go to the big house here. Run back down into the city. Can never remember the loot spawns in this house. It's so big, but it has so little loot by comparison. I really don't like looting this house, but I'm a little scared to go in there and try to battle those other guys. After having dropped so late. I'm a little peeved because I keep pressing center mouse button to free look while diving, and it's not working. It's screwing me up and making me move. Well, our teammates doing that work, not getting worked on. Did I look in that one? Nope. There wasn't even like a broke dick vest in here. That was a real bummer. Fucking pea shooter. Suppressive fire with the VSS. I'm doing all I can here, teammates. I can't do it all. Aw, oh, that dude in his fucking level 3 helmet. Oh my god, no ammunition. Let's see if I can get to the top of the hill. Finish this dude off. Oh, fuck! Apparently the full auto on here is not the way to go either. Oh my god. Where the fuck did he go? Oh shit! Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you! Oh fuck yeah. Yes! Kill! Oh! I got the one kill before they got me. What a bunch of dicks! Oh my god. Oh god. Change the scene, you peed? Was I low? Was I slow on the scene change? Damn it. One thing I like about PUBG that most PR games don't have are vehicles. The vehicles are a fun element to it, especially the dangerous motorcycle, the most dangerous vehicle in all of BRs. My rules in BR: always have a shoddy or an SMG. Never use snipers. Gaming poncho. Camper widow. Beat on Overwatch and PUBG. Never change.
Quit screwing around, Barback.
Turtle in here with a re-up on the sub. What? Much appreciated there, Turtle. Dude, would you believe I saved enough money to sub for 5 months? Hell yeah, Turtle. Good to hear. Good to hear, dude. I'm glad you're able to stop on in, buddy, and so much thanks for that sub, dude. Much appreciated. Much appreciated. Not straight, but in total. Yeah, no worries, man. No worries. Hey, dude, that is much appreciated, Turtle. Much appreciated. Hey, man, is that Ethernet cable still working for you by chance? I was hoping it was. I was actually out making a bunch of cables yesterday, trying to get a bunch of shit routed on my desk. So, and I was waiting for Juan to see when he wanted me to, or what length he needed if he wanted one. But, yeah, man, hopefully it's still working. If not, and you need another one, let me know. I'm still trying to get rid of this cable. The only subs I got are gifted. Ah, no worries, GMC. Being a sub is 100% absolutely not necessary. Okay, Widow, I actually gotta go. We'll see you, mate. Alrighty, GMC, you have a good night, buddy. We'll catch you later. Yeah, it does, but my dad doesn't let me use it anymore because my dog fucking chewed on it when he was a fucking puppy and my dad didn't tell me. Aww, damn. Well, shit. Well, I'll tell you what, those dogs, they can be quite lovable or quite annoying, Turtle. It still worked, but some of its wires are exposed. Okay. Well, you can always cut the wires and or put a new end on them. I don't know where he chewed it, if he chewed it towards the end or if he chewed it in the middle, but you can always make it work. But yeah, if you end up needing another one and you want something, there's like a specific length or something you need, Turtle, let me know, dude. Like I said, I'm in the process of making a few cables right now. So, Turtle, what's going on, buddy? You got some big plans for the summer here? Alright, we're umped up. I landed pretty far from my team here. That's got me a little worried. Woo-wee! It's like fireworks going off in this this neighborhood already. At 5.56 is so fucking heavy. Or 7.62, sorry. No backpack. Damn it. You've got to be shitting me. You've got to be kidding me. Backpack. Oh. Dropped everything before it really mattered. Got that comp on the AK. Makes me feel a tiny smidge bit better. Broke dick helmet. Better broke dick helmet than no helmet, they say. And he doesn't want me to use it because he doesn't want the Ethernet cord to go through the living room. The box is right in the middle of the living room. Ah, okay, okay. I see. So it's a routing issue. I can understand that. I went through a lot of effort to hide all the Ethernet cables that I have routed to the different devices throughout my house. It is kind of a pain and a little bit of a tripping hazard. Let's put the 2x on there. So far away from my teammates. The fuck are they shooting at? Let's get up there and see if we can do a little work. See if I can't see anybody there. Nope, don't need it. Oh shit, I thought this one had a roof. Alright. Oh, the best we get, or the least we can do is draw some fire, right? Oh shit. Draw fire is exactly what I did. Are they in that house? Oh shit. The fuck was that, man? What? Bullshit. I should have been ADSing. I fucked up bad. Ugh. So that means the only way we can have an Ethernet cord in the house is if we make it go outside, then make it go inside and into my laptop. Yeah, I mean, you can drill stuff through the floors and the walls, but, like, that's a much more involved process. I would highly recommend not doing that, Turtle, unless you, like, really, really, really want to go through a shitload of effort. It was completely unnecessary. I only did it a little bit because the router and modem in, like, my office is now in a nursery, so I'm actually doing it myself. It's a pain in the ass, man. I highly recommend you try to come up with another more creative way. Which you can do the, like, home nesting products, the ones where it's like, you essentially turn the wires that are in your walls for power, like your outlets, into Ethernet outlets or ports. What do they call them? Like a Nest network, something like that. You could use something like that if you wanted to get essentially an Ethernet connection to your laptop. But yeah, I mean, otherwise, yeah, you're routing stuff through walls, or you got cables laying on the floor, which neither one of those are great options either. Boy, I'm just getting pummeled here tonight. I think I've got I've got one kill? One kill. Nah, maybe two tonight? We'll have to go back and check the records. I'm so sorry I left for like 5 minutes. Can you just DM me what to do? Because now the stream froze and I can't make it work. Well, I'm gonna guess you're gonna want to just refresh. Let's see. Yeah, I'm working. Everything else is working on my side. I wanted to double check it. But yeah, I think you're just gonna have to refresh it, Turtle? Boy, I really don't love dropping Mansion. All right. Yeah. We'll, see if we get another squad here like last time. Shit, man. Well, I'm second to last to drop this time. I gotta get my drop, my PUBG drop skills back into form here. I feel like I'm constantly late or early dropping. It's working now. Did you see what I said? Yeah. No, I saw what you had. I saw what you said. No, I think the message is for whatever reason. Yeah, it looks like it was just out for a little bit for you there. All right, we got one squad here. Mel, what's going on? How was your weekend? Lots of good partying, good times. Well, I got a cool vest. Too bad I can't use a vest to kill anyone. Well, this is just great. This is just really fucking great. I'm in some deep shit here. All right, we've got a revolver. Oh shit, there we go. We got a mutant. We're dangerous again. Thought I just saw a guy run behind my building. Oh, god damn it. I saw that guy for sure. Ow. I have to be able to, like, hit between these fucking barriers in the window. See, was there anyone who dropped in here? Didn't appear so. All right. Get rid of this gun. It's a total junker. So much partying, so much food. It sounds like you had the kind of weekend that I had last weekend when I was gorging myself on vacation. But that is awesome, Mel. That is awesome. I was just saying if you could just DM me what to do, then I could convince my dad to run an Ethernet cord. Yeah, no, I could kind of give you the breakdown or send you a clip or a video or something of different routing options. There's been there's tons of different resources to kind of help walk you through all your options, but yeah, no, I could do that, Turtle. Not a problem. How did my team just get wiped? Oh, I think I saw a guy in there. Oh shit, my A key just fell off. What the fuck did I just see in here? I didn't see a dude. All shooting from in there? No. Shooting from in this house. See if I can get the drop on him. It's knocked out two. I knocked out two. I saw him running over there. I know he's trying to run behind me. I can't see his ass. I don't think he got around that house. I don't think he got behind me. But I'm fucking terrified that he did. Oh god, that rock scared the bejesus out of me. Thought that was him. I knocked two. He did not fucking res them both, did he? He sure shit did. Oh shit. Fuck that guy. Is that coming from inside the house? Where the fuck are they shooting from? Whoa! Oh. Motherfucker was right behind me. Thank you, my lord and savior, Widowmaker. Oh, no, Turtle. Absolutely not. Oh, how was your weekend, friend? My weekend was really good, Mel. I gorged myself multiple days. So we had date night last night, which was a ton of fun. I went to Carrabba's for dinner, but then we went to, I can't remember the name of the place. I think it's a chain. It's like Paint Me something another, but it's a clay pottery place where they have a bunch of pottery based stuff and then you can paint it. So we did dinner and then that, and then Cold Stone ice cream, of which I got a gotta have it of the like double triple Oreo. So I gorged myself last night. Then today was Father's Day. So I gorged myself again at breakfast with cinnamon rolls, bacon, and eggs. And then again tonight for dinner with some Montgomery and ribs and chicken and loaded baked potatoes. Oh my god, it was so delicious, but I just feel like I could, I need to not eat for a couple days. But the weekend was fantastic. The weekend was a shitload of fun. I just wish I hadn't ate so much. But it was a ton of good time. Tons of good times. Oh yeah. So fun. No, for sure. This is the last week of, I'll call it, staycation. I'm gonna end up taking off probably the Friday, July 5th. So we'll take off the 4th and the 5th. But this is the last sort of vacation that I have this year, because we'll be taking off a bunch of extra time at the end of the year for the new baby. So I kind of figured, like, I'm just going to go ham this weekend. You know, there's no point to holding back, because I'm not going to be going on any other trips. I'm not really doing any other staycations. I got a couple long weekends, like just regular long holiday weekends. So I figured, you know what, let's just throw all caution to the wind. We're going to get crazy amounts of ice cream. We're going to just eat whatever we want, do whatever we want, be lazy, do a bunch of shit, just whatever, just go with it. Just whatever feels right, do it. So it was a pretty good weekend for that. I'd say I kind of wish I'd laid off the ice cream last night because I woke up with a stomachache. but otherwise, it was actually a pretty good evening last night. Pretty good day today. So I'm not looking forward to getting back to the work grind, but maybe it'll be nice to get back into a normal groove, you know. So. C'est la vie. Yeah, for sure. But I did, today, Father's Day was pretty cool today, along with eating crap tons of food. I put some new trim pieces up along the desk, so we actually have a thinner piece of trim. I started to route some of the LEDs. I rerouted and redid all my cable management, which I'm really pleased with the way it came out, because I kind of screwed up the way that I did my cable management, when I first put my desk together, because I didn't leave enough slack in all of my USB devices, so like all my mice and cameras and all that shit. So this time I rerouted it all, and it came out actually much, much better this time. So. Now that I've got the routing all worked out, I need to finish the LEDs. I've got new heavier duty actuators coming in tomorrow. They are delivered tomorrow. And then, really? I'm kind of done on the desk until somebody wants me to build them one. It's kind of like there's not really much else for me to do with mine. I'm kind of just happy with the way it is. At least for the moment, until I think of something new. Oh man, I can't pick up that fucking scope. No backpack out here. This blows. Fuck that ammo. Nobody needs it. More optics that I can't pick up. Shit, I can't remember how to get up on those fucking things. Is there like a spot for me to climb and jump? That is critical. Oh, we got some heist action. Mel's gonna be catching up on those points in no time. Or those bucks in no time. Where in the hell did my teammates go? I thought they were all over here with me. Looks like there was only one that dropped over here with me. Alright, at least we got a vest. We're doing some work. Ugh. Broke dick backpack. And a sweet camo cap. We're actually not bad for the circle here either. This is good. This is good. Wait, why can't you pick those up? What you say? We pick which pick what up? Pick which piece up? Level 2 helmet. Part of it is the fact that I didn't have a backpack, so you can only carry a limited inventory. Like, until you have a backpack that's big enough. Aw, man. Crappy backpack. Back by the shipping containers. Oh, yeah. So I can't, I didn't have a backpack, so it wouldn't let me. There is a motorcycle over here. We'll drive this over to the next stop. Actually, we're gonna go help our friends who seem to be shooting at somebody here. Like, I haven't played Royale before. Oh my gosh. Mel, it was the best $30 I ever spent on a video game. Like, for $30, I've gotten more than enough playtime and enjoyment out of this title than I ever could have planned on. I would highly recommend PUBG if you think BR is something you would like to play. Plus, you can also get this game on sale for a lot less. I don't know how often they run it, but I know that you can definitely get it on sale for a lot less. Like, $15 or whatever, every so often. What? You can't fucking jump up on that? That seems stupid. You've got to be fucking kidding me. Come on. I've really lost my edge here. I don't even know how to jump up on this shit. Oh, this car. That's how. All right, now I'm in business. I just have to keep an eye out for fucking enemies. Level 3 vest. Cheek pad for the sniper that I'm dreaming of getting. Aww. I was a little amped up thinking I was gonna get it right there. Another extended mag quick draw. Some decent shit up here, man. M4? Let's take it. Let's take it. I don't know if the M4 is still the go-to or not, but I'll tell you what, it'll always be my go-to. Oh shit, I missed it. Damn it. My teammates are all running away. Best go catch up with them. PUBG, really? I haven't played PUBG before, but I'll have to add it to the list. That's not bad at all. Do you use Steam for it, or is there another platform? So, it's on Steam. You can... I don't know that I've ever seen it for sale, like, on a Steam sale. But I know that they will run... Like, they will discount the game... I don't know. Every couple... not a couple months. Maybe, like, every 6 months. Like, twice a year, maybe not, maybe during the summer sale or winter sale, but, like, definitely a couple times a year. I would, I'd venture to say this next summer sale, it very well could be discounted at that time versus some of the past ones where it hasn't been. But, I need to probably, keep an eye out or put some Google alerts for the Steam summer sale, because last year I missed the summer sale. Like, I was like, oh, why isn't the summer sale happened yet? And then, lo and behold, it happened fucking 2 weeks prior, and I was just oblivious to the fact that, you know, Steam put everything on sale. I guess there wasn't any really super good deals on games that I didn't already have, so, like, all the news, items of people talking about all the great deals, I just brushed right over. not even realizing that the summer sale was going on. Even still, 30 isn't bad. 100%. For a game, for $30, I get equally as much joy out of this, maybe a tiny bit less than a number of $60 AAA titles, like, including DLC. But, like, BR has to be sort of your thing, or at least you have to be open to trying BR, which, you know, I was talking with GMC earlier. PUBG is my favorite BR. There's other ones that I really still like to play. I don't like to play Fortnite. I do like to play Apex. I do like to play Blackout. But PUBG is the BR that I was saying earlier. When I long to play a BR, PUBG is the BR that I want to play. I'd like to get back into it a little bit more, kind of like on a regular basis, so my skills don't feel like they depreciate so viciously. Because I feel like it's kind of a use it or lose it skill set. So, I mean, maybe when Black Ops 4 DLC cycle is done and we're kind of mixing in, playing a little bit of Infinite Warfare Zombies and something else like PUBG, I'll be able to grind it a little bit more and keep my edge. Like I said, I feel like I've lost quite the edge that I previously had. But everyone I know who's bought it for $30, even if they weren't super, super into PUBG, have all sort of accepted, like, hey, this game was well, well worth the $30. All right, I'm in the car. Where the hell do you want to go? Are you going nowhere? Well, shit, fuck that. I'm going to at least go down to this guy, our partner down here. He seems to be hanging out down here. Why wouldn't I go hang out with him? Dadgum. I miss some of the late night PUBG runs that we used to do with the crew. And I'll never forget my very first time playing PUBG. I had never watched gameplay and really understood what the hell these guys were doing. And the idea of BR was really only explained to me as, like, yeah, it's kind of like the Hunger Games, but, you know, a video game. And the clip exists. I'd have to dig it up. But essentially my first encounter with people was a pure fucking panic. Like, oh my God, there's people there. Just shoot, just shoot, just unload everything you got. Try to kill them, try to kill them. There was lots of screaming, not a lot of high-performance play, but it was a fantastically good time. Fantastically good time. It was me, Ludo, Kyle, and Micah, if I remember right. It was a silly good time, silly good time. There was a lot of meme-worthy moments when we were playing PUBG regularly. The fact that my bad driving to this day sticks out is a testament. I've brought the meme to life because I just keep feeding into it. My terrible driving just won't go away because mentally I can't let go of being a bad driver. Oh, take the grip. Take the gun, leave the cannoli this time. Got some loot lords, I love it. Damn, I don't have that much health. I just realized that. Don't need that. Really don't need all that 7... I don't need all that 9mm anymore. I just realized that. Make sure I've got my guns all the way kitted up. We all have our moments. True. Some of us have more than we should. But it's all good. It's all good. Where you guys want to go here? Where you guys want to go? I'm really holding out for a sniper here. Got the extended mag and I got the cheek pad. I just need the gun. This was the house we already looted. Anybody have an SLR? Just something I can make use of this shit with. Got that 4X, but I feel like I'm kind of cheating myself by only having it on this other hunk of junk. Ooh, a bunch of 3Xs? Ech. Ech. In case I get a canted sight. I don't know if you need any of that shit. Oh, there's another cheek pad over here. I don't need it. I don't want it. My friend's trying to communicate with me, but I can't communicate with him. Sneak, sneak, sneak in the grass. I'm a snake. I'm a sneaky snake. Punk's not dead. Man, I had time to go grab another beer. I am empty now. We're on the skinny side of the circle. Nobody's gonna come over here. Sneak, sneak like a snake. Ooh, we got a car inbound. I just talked about not having anything to, Oh, fuck you, dude! My fucking frag! God damn it, it bounced off that motherfucker's face. He got, like, he slid right into the doorway right as I was throwing the grenade, and then it bounced right back. I didn't hear it drop on the floor, which was really, really weird. All right, we're gonna have one last beer, and then we'll get back to it. Stand by, guys. Shall return uno momento. Man, I don't know why, but my, the, like, weirdest shit is going on with my, like, whatever, be right back cam. It's, like, doing this weird flaky thing at the bottom. It's alright, I need to just buy a third webcam. Right now I'm using my phone as my, like, rear piece. And it works, it serves, but like, whoa.
Quit screwing around, Barback.
Hey, a happy Father's Day. Thank you so much, Juan, and thank you so much for that subscription, dude. Much appreciated. It's been a good Father's Day. It's been a good one. We've been eating around the world. It feels like the last 7 days, I guess. But it's been a good one. Today was a good day. I got to work on my desk, tweak a couple things, work on a bunch, cleaning up a bunch of cable management and whatnot. I ate my face off. It's been a good day. Even had a couple beers with dinner. Like I said, life's been treating me good. But thank you so much for that subscription, buddy. Said you guys are the glue that keeps this bar together. I tell you what. Let's see. We're due to have a much deeper that match was just a bunch of malarkey, if you ask me. I don't know how in the hell I went down so fast. Well, I do, because I threw a grenade into the back of my teammate's head and it dropped on the ground, and I was blissfully unaware that it was sitting there. We need to set it off here. We need to go freaking ham and light some peeps up. Pochinki is my city, and that's where we're going to do our finest work. So, Juan, what have you been up to this weekend, buddy? Are we going Milta or are we going Pachinki here? Alright, he says Pachinki. The vote is Pachinki. EL Juan really wants Milta. Oh my god, you assholes. Are we going Milta or are we going Pachinki? Let's see where everybody goes here. Alright, it seems like everybody's going Pachinki. Good. Much stronger choice here. Ooh, I took a big TV down to my porch and finished Lucifer on Netflix. That sounds like a pretty good day, pretty good day. Lucifer is so good? Interesting, interesting. I've never watched it, I don't even know of the show. How is the Gossip Girl adventure going? Very good. We watched, 4 episodes this past weekend? So we're right in the thick of Jenny being a drug dealer. She's so freaking stupid. So the last episode we watched, Jenny got caught by Rufus and Lily while they were having their spit and spat. They got caught with the drugs and she, like, ran off to go be with her boyfriend, her drug-dealing boyfriend. And Rufus and Lily are still in the outs, and Dan and Vanessa finally hooked up. Like, well, besides the threesome that they had, they finally hooked up. And chaos is going on right now with poor Chuck Bass and his mother. I don't like that storyline. Nothing good can come of it. Well, I guess not so much a storyline. I don't like Chuck's mom. I feel like nothing good is going to come of this woman. But we are fully engaged in Gossip Girl. It's going good. I'm enjoying it. So we're season 3, like episode 15 or something like that, I think is what it is. Hear lots of shots, but my gun's not yet loaded. You gonna breach one of these houses here, buddy? Running towards the shots. Oh, that was my teammate running by me. Hell, who really knows anymore? I feel like this is a decent house for vantage points, but I can't see anything. I don't see any people, any muzzle flashes. Still don't have an optic. So much shit. Like Crush maybe he's fighting someone. Oh shit, yeah. Oh man, our boy EL just got lit the fuck up. Waiting for this dude to back out of there. Fuck you, dick. You thirsted my friend, so I thirsted you. And my friend, I mean some stranger on the internet. You are not wrong. So I'm still Team Serena, even though she really sucks. And Blair just really, like, Blair has yet to truly grow on me. Like, she just is, she's not someone that I can love. I don't know what it is about her, but I just cannot stand to love her. Serena kind of pisses me off, but she's not the worst. suppress that motherfucker, even though these bombs are going off. Shit. You've got to be fucking kidding me. I ran out of ammo and missed every single fucking shot. Honestly, Nate is a gem. I agree on Nate. The Serena trip storyline, like the whole, oh, Serena's breaking up this home, and like, Serena, come on, you're better than that. What are you doing with Trip? He totally sucks. And it's like you saw him, like, betraying Serena so easily. And it was just a real shame, like, that from that story perspective, Serena just looks like she sucks really, really badly. The her and Nate thing, I really like. I'm not in love with Vanessa and Dan. I like the friend storyline more than I do them as, like, partners. It's a shame. I guess deep down inside, I just really long for Serena and Dan to be together for forever. We'll see. I never liked Vanessa much at all, and yep, the Serena and Trip thing was just silly to me. It was so silly. But, yeah, Vanessa doesn't do it for me. She's kind of like, I don't know. I enjoy her character a little bit. Like, I liked the storylines of when she was trying to save the bar and Chuck Bass was, like, a frenemy a little bit. Like, I liked that stuff. But her as a love interest for Dan, I'm not into that. All right, we're going shelter then. I guess I'm gonna jump out and try to find something along this road or this road. Fly as far as we can here. Chuck, while generally a douche, is probably my second favorite. Chuck, I really love Chuck's character a lot. I'd say he's not my favorite. Truth be told, I can't really decide who my favorite is. But he's definitely top three. And I'd say that, like, Chuck in season one, like, Chuck season one, episodes 1-5, is a total douche. But then he really starts to show a lot of kind of, like, endearing qualities, I feel like, pretty fast. Like, when he, in season two, when he basically tells Jenny, like, hey, if you ever move in here, like, I'm gonna move out, because, like, he obviously tried to, like, assault her, which that was pretty douchey, but that was, like, episodes 1-5. Like, you can definitely see that Chuck Bass has a major turn for being a better human, pretty quickly in the series. Which makes it's kind of wild, because that means whatever storyline they put together for him was deliberate. Like, they wanted to show him being a total fucking douche. And then they were like, oh, well, we're going to have, like, this story of redemption for him. Which is pretty cool. And we'll see where it goes from the overall series. But, yeah, season one, I was pretty like, damn, Chuck sucks at the beginning. And then, oh, no, yeah, Chuck Bass has, like, got some serious redeeming qualities. Plus, he, like, while he is from, you know, a rich family, like, you know, he's got some demons he's battling here, you know, that kind of story, I think, is interesting to see unfold and see told on TV. Is there, like, something good in here? There is not. Oh, man, I was really hoping to see a dune buggy up here. No love. I'm not so sure that Chuck is meant to be with Blair either. Holy shit, those guys got lit up to start. I would love to tag somebody out of the sky with this pistol. How the fuck are we so late getting here? Those guys had to have pulled their parachutes immediately. Who the fuck is that car? I hear it, but don't see it. Oh, those guys are rolling out from shelter. How the fuck did they get to shelter so fast? All right. So there's definitely some people in here. Now the million-dollar question is, can I kill them with my single pistol here? There's nothing left but broke dick stuff. Level one shit. Boo. Nobody wants all this broke dick level one stuff. I'm anxious if I'm going to find a gun at this point. Hollows. Pfft. Oh, of course we find the shotgun. I'm just looking for somebody's sloppy seconds here. An M16. Yeah. Oh, an SKS. Damn it. Why did my teammates have to die? Of course. The game that I finally get a sniper. Well, I heard that car again. How fucking far away? Oh, I'm like center circle too. I mean, I left a shitload of loot in there potentially, but I'm kind of anxious to see where these people are. Tino! What's up, Tino? 1223. Well, since I'm a solo squad here, we'll just chance it in the red. Why not?
I'm drunk.
What's it matter?
Everybody's drunk.
Tino, appreciate that follow. Welcome to being a regular here at the Drinkery. We're pretty chill. Mostly savory group. We have a tendency to be unsavory every now and then. But welcome. Come on, get inside this house before I get blown up. Ooh, ooh, hoo, hoo. Felt like I was close. Got that broke dick level one vest for cash money. Cash money. We can't be stopped with it. Oh, this basically means we're indestructible with a level 2. It really blows that my teammates had to just die like that. You know it? It really, really does. Whenever teamwork is involved, unsavory comes out. Yeah. We're notorious for being ambiguous on whether or not we are good or bad teammates. It's kind of our MO on this channel. And with this group of players. Probably don't need this handgun anymore. Aggressively communicating. We just want to communicate as quickly and aggressively as possible. That's all we really care to do. Don't need the hollow, don't need the 2x anymore. Probably should have spotted that drop, seen where it was going. Could have done something with it. Camped it or something, you know? Been just a little wild with it. So I am sort of on the far, like, the plane drop was far to the west here. So, I mean, I could easily run into people who drove this far over, but by and large, right, I should be on the less populous side of the circle. I'm just going to be a loot monger here for a little while. Find people, loot my face off. I mean, that's why they made the game, right? So you could loot your face off. This sniper tower is kind of pointless, because you really can't see anything down the hill. Up the hill is hardly anything, because, right, it's like, you can see that one ridge. Like, none of these towers are really tall. I guess that's why there's so many of them, right? So you can cover all the spot with just many, many bodies, many, many eyes. I was back down the hill towards the shelters. Let's see what we can spot here. Whole lot of nothing through those trees. Alrighty, I'm off to bed. Hope you get to ease back into work tomorrow. I appreciate it, Mel. I appreciate it. You have a good start to your week as well. We will hopefully see you Tuesday night, Mel. Hopefully you'll be back to playing soon as well. What, next, like next weekend? Will you be all settled in? Always takes a little bit of time to get everything unpacked and set up just ever so perfectly. I'm still working to set up my desk so perfectly. All right. Oh, we got one enemy. He's getting pop-shotted. By who? The dude right there on that tree line. Oh, fuck you, dude. Oh my. I was trying to fucking go prone. Hopefully in the next week or so, but TBD. I understand, Mel. Well, cheers to you, and safe travels the rest of the way, and we'll catch you next time. I am going to go ahead and end on that note. I was hoping to finish with a big dub, although it was really going to be a really tough grind in a solo squad situation there. But guys, as I was saying, I will be playing again on Tuesday night. Hopefully we'll have Mel be joining us sometime later in the week or maybe next week. Should be live about 8:45, 9 p.m. on Tuesday and Thursday this week, guys. Picking back up our regular times. It will be a little bit later, I'm guessing, just because getting my son back on his normal sleep schedule after a week of vacation is going to be a serious, serious chore. So we'll try to hit our typical 8:45 start time, but it could slip a little bit later if I am continuing to fight him to go to bed at his normal bedtime. Guys, let me drop a couple links off to you. Let's turn back on Synergy real quick. The first link, guys, is going to be to the Brew Crew Discord server. If you guys are looking to hang out, party up, play some PUBG, some Black Ops 4, guys, pop into the Brew Crew Discord, say hi. We're always in there looking for games and hanging out, guys. If you're looking to keep up with when the channel's going live or hang out offline, guys, follow me on Twitter. That is my link, at Widowmaker Dukes. And guys, we've got the Drinkery Discord. That is a Discord dedicated to this channel, as well as the content that we produce here and some of the projects that we've been working on, namely my custom sit-stand desk, guys. You can see some of the pictures and progress that's there. I need to post a most recent progress picture because, well, I've made some progress on it since I last posted on there. Again, guys, be well. Hopefully life treats you good for your Monday. Well, I guess it is Monday if you're on the East Coast. But guys, be well, and we'll hopefully see you on Tuesday, tentatively 8:45 p.m. Until then, adios. Whoop.